Hello everyone, hoping that you are doing good. In this video we are going to discuss some important questions from partnership section. This is the second video in our partnership series. In the previous video we have discussed some questions in partnership and we have also discussed some basic tips and techniques to be followed to solve the partnership problems. In this video we are going to see some more problems. So without making any delay, let's get started. P and Q entered into a partnership with 30,000 rupees and 60,000 rupees. After 4 months, P invested 15,000 rupees more while Q withdrew 30,000 rupees. Find the share of P in the annual profit of 1 lakh rupees. In the question, he was given that P has invested 30,000 rupees, Q has invested 60,000 rupees, and 4 months later, P invested some additional 15,000 rupees and Q has taken away the 30,000 rupees from his investment and he is asking to find the share of P, P's profit, P's share in the annual profit. Annual profit means the business ran for 12 months. So the hint is given and the profit is 1 lakh rupees. Let's see how to solve this problem. As stated, as per the question, P has invested 30,000 rupees for 4 months. So 30 into 4. To make it simple, I removed those additional zeros. So 30 into 4. Plus 45 into 8. After 4 months, he added 15,000 rupees to his investment. So 30 plus 15 gives 45,000, and that 45,000 was there for up to 8 months. 45 into 8. And Q has invested 60,000 rupees. After 4 months, he has taken away 30,000 rupees from his investment. So he will be having 30,000 for 8 months of period. And after the simplification, we get 120 plus 360. 240 plus 240, that gives 480 is to 480, and cancellation will be, we get the profit ratio as 1 is to 1, that is P will be getting one part and Q will be getting one part. The total profit is given as 1 lakh rupees. So P's share is obviously 50,000 rupees, since 1 by 2 into 1 lakh is 50,000 rupees. So option B is the correct answer. Let's move to the second question. I hope you understood the first question. Now let's move to the second one. In the second question, it is given that A and B invested 90,000 rupees and 1,20,000 rupees in a business. After 4 months, A invested 10,000 rupees more, and after 2 more months, B withdrew 20,000 rupees. If they earned a total profit of 1,86,000 rupees, find the difference between the profit earned by them. This question is also like first one itself, but a few changes are there, few variations are there. In the question, it was given that A has invested 90,000, B invested 1,20,000 in a business, that's okay. After 4 months, A invested 10,000 more, that means after 4 months, his investment will be 1 lakh rupees. And after 2 more months means 4 months plus 2 months, like that we have to calculate, 6 months. That is, after 6 months, B withdraw 20,000 rupees from his investment. That is, his initial investment was 1,20,000 rupees. After 6 months, that is 4 plus 2 months, he will be taking away the 20,000 rupees and he will be left with 1 lakh rupees. If they earned a profit, total profit of 1,86,000 rupees, find the difference between the profit earned by them. We have to identify the difference of their profits. So let's move how to solve this. Here, A has invested 90,000 rupees for 4 months, so 90 into 4. After 4 months, he has added 10,000 more, so 90 plus 10 equal to 100, that is 1 lakh rupees. His 1 lakh rupee investment will be for 8 months. And the B has invested 1,20,000 rupees after 6 months, that is 4 plus 2 months. He has taken away the 20,000 rupees, so 120 minus 20 gives 100. His 1 lakh rupee investment will be for 6 months. And after the simplification, we get 90 into 4, 360, 100 into 8, 800, 120 into 6, 720, 100 into 6 is 600. So after cancellation, we get, with 4 we will cancel it, 4 2s are 8, 4 9s are 36, 4 3s are 12, 4 3s are 12. A will be getting 29 parts, B will be getting 33 parts, and the difference is 4 parts, because in the question he has asked the difference of their profits. So 4 by total number of parts, that is 29 plus 33 gives 62. 29 plus 33 gives 62. 4 by 62 into 1,86,000. On cancellation, we get 12,000 rupees. So the difference between the profits is 12,000 rupees. Option C is the correct answer. So many students do A's profit individually, and again they will identify the B's profit. Afterwards, they will subtract B minus A, and they will get the answer. But that is very lengthy procedure. We should not do like that in competitive examinations. Whenever in the question, if he or she is asked to identify the difference between the profits, we have to subtract their ratios, and then we have to calculate. Like that, we have to do. So never find out the individual profits and do subtraction. That's incorrect. Now let's move to the third one, final question. P and Q started a business by investing their capitals in the ratio of 4:9. After 3 months, P has increased capital to 1.5 times his capital. After 4 months, Q withdraw 1/3 of the capital. If they got 5,400 as the annual profit means 12 months, find the share of P in the profit. So he has asked to find out the P's share. In this question, the investment amount was not given, only the ratios were given. The ratios were 4:9. We'll consider their investments as 4x and 9x respectively. After 3 months, P has increased the capital to 1.5 times. That means 1.5 times. 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 1 3, 3 by 2 times. After 5 more months, Q withdraw 1/3 of capital. If they got 5,400 as the annual profit, find the share of P in the profit. Let's see how to solve this. In the question, P's investment is 4x. So after 3 months, he has increased his investment with 1.5 times. That is 3/2 × 4x. On cancellation, we get 6x. After 3 months, his investment will be 6x. This investment will be for 9 months. 6x × 9. And coming to Q has invested 9x rupees. After 8 months, he has withdraw 1/3 of his investment. 1/3 means 9x/3. His investment is 9x. So when we taken away the 1/3 of it, we get 3 3s are 3x. So 3x, 9x minus 3x equal to 6x. 6x × 4. After the complete simplification, we get 12x plus 54x is to 72x plus 24x. That gives 66x plus is to 96x. He has asked the P's share of profit. So P's share means 66x by 66 plus 6 plus 96x. That gives 162x. On cancel, first of all, we'll cancel with 9. 9 ones, 9 8 is 72, 9 6 54. 00. Again, we'll cancel with 6. 6 3 is 18. 6 3 is 18. 6 11 is 66. Afterwards, 3 ones, 3 200s. So, 200 into 11 is 2200. Therefore, P's share of profit is 2200. Like that, we have to calculate. Option A is the right answer. Hoping that you have understood the questions and solutions. Thank you for watching. Keep learning and be happy.